childbirth in the past, and she says urinary symptoms with frequency every hour, nocturia at least three times, urgency and hesitancy. And she has a diagnosis of fourth degree cystocele. At voiding cystogram, you can see a severe bladder prolapse with minimum residual post-voiding. In urodynamics, there is obstruction with stress incontinence due to urethral hypermobility. So, this is what you see in this woman, this severe cystocele. And this is the cystogram. So you can see the decentus of the bladder neck. And this is the cystoscopy, flexible cystoscopy. This is, you can see actually the bladder neck. And you can see the bladder neck prolapsing during cystoscopy. So this is urodynamics. This is before cystocele reduction with high voiding pressure. And the voiding pressure drops after cystocele reduction. This is a urethral pressure profile. And so for this total pelvic prolapse, Thierry Piochot is going to perform a sacrocolpopexy. Thank you for your attention.
Possiamo passare alla visione interna del... Benissimo, grazie. Sì. Yes, we have now the internal images.
So do we have... C'est la plaque? Hello. Do you have contact with the room?
Yes. We are just listening to you.
Okay. Good morning. Good morning, everybody.
We have wonderful images.
We are going to start the last.
Good morning to you all.
We are going to start the last procedure of the day, and as the case have been presented for you. It's a case of a lady, 70 years old, with a very high level of prolapse because, as you have seen on the pictures, she has a cystocele of degree 4 with hysteroptose because we have a little problem of coagulation, so we have to wait. It's correct?
Yes, we listened to the presentation of the case. So your technique is using three suprapubic trochers, three ancillary trochers. Are they placed?
For his tool. And we have the famous Dr. Courtois, which is a laparoscopic urologist, and we have a large experience of this surgery. And we will be in charge to give us a good exposition of vaginal exposition because you are going to see that with such a level of prolapse, you have a very important dissection of vagina, which is in
the uterus from outside. A wonderful view for the uterus from inside.
On avance.
I saw you place a stitch just to hold the uterus.
Pardon?
You're placing a straight needle in the uterus in order to hold it.
Yes, you have the contact. Yes.
Yes, you have the contact. Yes.
Am I with the room?
Okay.
Zoom a bit.
Pardon?
Yes, we have the inside image.
Okay, so we are going to fix now uterus with a very simple system of transparietal stitch. with the right needle, and we are going to just to give us a maximal exposition of the posterior dissection of vagin. We need to be free in access with Douglas pouch and the posterior limit of vagin, and with this kind of fixation of uterus, it's the best way to get free posterior access of dissection. So we have started the
we
first
are with
step.
You now, because I think we are just showing us a very important moment of the procedure,
okay.
Just the choice of the right plane.
So, okay, doucement, Nick. Do you have endoscopic view?
Yes.
Yes, because I have not back. Right. Okay. So, do you have internal view?
Yes, yes, yes,
okay,
definitely.
So we have
start, wonderful internal view, high
we have
definition.
We start the first step of preparation of sacral fixation, which is access to the sacral ligament and to be sure that fixation of the mesh will be possible. So after giving free Douglas pouch with fixation of uterus, we go on sacral ligament and we have to recognize if it's possible to access to it and in the last part of the procedure to fix the mesh. So to find contact with the sacral ligament, we catch peritoine, and just with a little movement of traction between assistant and surgeon, we give a traction to the very thin part of peritoine with just a little coagulation, we incise peritoine, and with the gas, it's quite easy to find the space to arrive in contact with the white aspect of sacral ligament, and you need to have a tactile contact with ligament to be sure that it is not a vascular structure and to be sure that it will be possible to pass a needle later to fix the mesh. So the second step is to prepare the place of the mesh, and as you know, the mesh must be covered by peritoine at the end of the procedure to avoid any risk of contact between bowels and mesh. And we have to prepare a place which will allow a peritonization of the mesh later. So we go in this dissection of peritoneum, just in a free space between fat tissue of mesosigmoid and just between contact with ureter, which is very closed, and you see it here, which is very closed, and we have to drive this dissection very safely. Yes, ureter is little dilatation, but I have to precise that with this very important cystocell, you have an inclusion of trigona and the distal part of ureter in the cystocell, so it's a reason for which you have a little dilatation of ureter. So very gently, very safely, we go on this preparation of the bed of the mesh, and you need to take time because you have some possibilities of crossing vessels, crossing vents, and exact, and you have to avoid any problem of bleeding because it can induce hematoma in contact with the mesh. Monica, we go on more distally, and progressively you arrive in contact with the uterosacral ligament. So we are going to move the... Ah oui, elle est très grosse. Attends, pas trop. Pas trop, tout à l'heure. So we have a very, very important cystocell. So we will achieve the passage of the mesh later. Okay, so... Doucement. Qu'est-ce qui glisse? Ouais. So... Now we are going to start. Je ne suis pas sûr que la bipolaire. Okay, mets-moi en traction. We are going to start. Hein, tu te mets en traction. Tu me supportes au-dessus. Voilà. So we are going to start insertion of peritoneum. And I must be very superficially to let the gas define a space of dissection, and perhaps I am too close with uterus. I think it's better to go more, a little more easily, because I think that good space will be here. Yeah, because I'm too close with. I must be very carefully because I have a level 4. Or perhaps, so I don't know exactly what limit of rectum and bladder in contact with the vaginal prolapse. Je vais voir, j'ai pas mon plan parfait. Oui, on va le rejoindre par là parce que non, pas trop. Voilà. Non, elle me gêne, ouais, plutôt qu'autre chose. Ouais. I'm going to join the lateral and medial approach. So here it's just a problem of finding the good space. C'est pas terrible ce que je fais là. Monique, prends-le comme ça. Regarde, je pense qu'il faut que j'aille. Je suis trop près du. Non, ça me gêne un peu ça. Prends la. So we find. We try to find. Yeah. Okay, so. I arrive in contact with the free space, and I think that it will be the good space to develop dissection. Because, as you can observe, when you have a very important prolapse, you can be wrong in your first dissection, and it induces a wrong plane for all the procedure, and it can be very difficult to find a good landmarks and very dangerous for the plane of rectum. So I start to find a free space, so I am going to enlarge access on the middle line and the left side. I remind you that in laparoscopic surgery, you always have to try to be symmetric in your dissection to avoid a false evaluation of the landmark. And progressively, we are going to develop a space between rectum and posterior aspect of vagin, and to start the dissection, which have to drive you in contact with the levator muscle. So I enlarge. Here I have no risk with your tear because there are more laterals. Oui, un tout petit peu bonique ici, là. And progressively, you can admit that the space of dissection is quite easy because you have good space and gas is helping you to find this space. So I need to divide this last attachment of peritoneum on the right side. And I think that now surely will be possible to use the blade to give a good exposition of vagin. Ici, abaisse-moi le rack. Oui, ouais, très bien, très bien. Non, au contraire, je voulais que tu me soulèves un peu, excuse-moi. Oui. So you see, posterior aspect of vaginal limit, which is here. A free space between rectum and vagin, which is here. Here it's little attachment, little adhesion between rectum and vagin, and with very, very slow use of scissors, it's possible to go on in this posterior dissection. And every time, you have to be attentive to avoid risk of close contact with rectum. Pardon? Oui. So we have to stop just a minute. So I go very progressively with the lateral liberation of posterior aspect of vagin. Yes. Ici. Yes. OK, alors montre-moi au milieu maintenant. So we are progressively we advance in the posterior mobilization between vagin and rectum. And I have to be sure to have the good space. And I think, yes. Okay, so between the two, no. So you can see, I think that I have a good contact with the posterior limit of vagine. I think that on lateral side, it's the beginning of the section of pararectal area to find the levator muscle, and I have just this lateral attachment, and I must be very careful because it's possible to have a pedicle and would like to avoid injuries of this kind of pedicles, mainly to avoid the problem of bleeding, but to preserve functional aspect of rectal function, so to try to avoid section or coagulation of pedicle if it's not necessary. So I think that at this level you find lateral aspect of rectum, and in this part surely we are going to find with contact with levator muscle, so I would like to enlarge a little more my lateral access. And at this level of dissection, you need to have a visual contact with the muscle to be sure that the fixation of your mesh will be with a good, safe limit of separation with the rectum, and to avoid any risk of injuries of it. So I think that you have to... Ouais, doucement, Monique, parce que... I try to have a complete hemostasis. I am waiting before decision. So I go on the right side now. Please, soulève un petit peu vers le haut le vagin. It's a strong prolapse. Yes. So as we know, we think that montre-moi ici, Monique, s'il te plaît. We think that posterior treatment of this kind of prolapse is very important to give a complete reparation of the prolapsus and to avoid posterior recidive in the future. If you just treat the entire part of the prolapse, it is sure that you are going to induce posterior movement of vagina and the recidive of prolapse in the medial and posterior part. Oui. Attends, c'est ici, hein. Yes. Alors, donne-moi une petite vue d'ensemble en arrière. So, perhaps it's becoming more clear now for you. I have a rectum which appears to be free on the middle line of the field. I see that I need to divide this last attachment and very progressively, because it's possible that rectum is very closed. Vas-y, prends-moi vers le... Voilà, très bien. I try to avoid to cut directly because I don't know if there is not a reply of rectum at this part. So, you know, I prefer that I have a little dissection with distal part of scissors and then to divide and to cut just when I'm sure that I'm no risk with rectum. I hope that I'm no risk with rectum. Ouais, montre-moi ici. So, ici, hein. A little pellicule and ouais. A little bleeding, which is so it's okay. So it's montre-moi. It's becoming more clear. We have a posterior aspect of vagin. We have lateral dissection of rectum on the left side, and as you can observe, we have a very good and very large access on the levator muscle plane, which will be sufficient to fix the mesh. Just a little bleeding part here. Okay, and I have to complete on the right side now. And I think that really access is very deep. And I think that it will be necessary that I enlarge a superficial access to be sure to have possibility to move my needle under and to place the needle exactly where I want in the contact with the muscle. Monique, écarte-moi un petit peu vers le haut là. Regarde. Écarte-moi un petit peu vers le haut, Monique. So you see limit of rectum, which is here. So really, with this kind of very large prolapse, you must be very attentive because of risk of a large position of rectum and progressively access on the fat, which is always present in contact with levator muscle and behind the fat, the muscle. So we are going to take a back movement to show you. Monique, peut-être que je vais être obligé de m'élargir un petit peu plus ici, tu vois, parce que je suis au fond d'un... Now I can enlarge because I'm sure of my landmarks. And it's just to give you a good... Francisco,
ouais.
Tu écoutes?
Ouais.
Doucement. Voilà. Attends, je voudrais finir l'hémostase de ce petit pellicule que j'ai pas envie de. Ok, montre-moi s'il te plaît. Non, ça va. J'ai envie de le laisser peut-être. Montre-moi au fond. Voilà, je vais m'élargir en avant. Ouais. Vas-y, élargis-moi en avant. So it's okay now. So if you agree, tu prends un back movement, Monique, pas trop, c'est pas la peine d'enlever le périmysium. Prends un mouvement en arrière, voilà. So if you agree, we have achieved the time of this posterior dissection, and we have a very safe aspect on identification of rectum limits, and we have a very large access on the plane of the muscle to fix the mesh, and we don't need any more dissection because the only objective of this time is to give a place for a posterior fixation of the mesh, and the mesh will be fixed on each side of the rectum on the muscular plane, and with the curve crossing above limit of rectum and fixed on the left part of levator muscle. And I will achieve with the medial fixation of the mesh in the vagin with a very superficial point. Zoom un petit peu, s'il te plaît, j'ai toujours ce petit point de saignement. Ouais, je voudrais faire un peu loin du rectum. It's okay. So we are going to introduce now mesh. So it's so the posterior part of the mesh is it's a large. So I need to prepare before going in a deep part of field. I need to prepare a placement of needle on the needle under, and I must to be in one third of curve of a needle with a small antiversion of needle to be sure to have a free movement. So I'm going to pick the muscle at the upper and distal part of the windows, and I'm going to go back just to be on the middle line and to be sure that I will have visual contact to avoid risk of injury of rectum at the end of the movement of needle. So I present needle. As you can observe, a very nice passage in the muscle. And because of my previous position of needle in the needle under, I am sure that with my grasper I avoid any contact with rectum, and I'm sure that in going on a movement of needle, my stitch is fixed without any risk of contact with the rectum. So we are going to down. Attends pas trop vite, Monique. We are going to down the mesh to approach the leg of mesh with muscle. Okay, so you have to be sure that your mesh has a full contact with muscle. Monica is going to show me place of the knot, and I prepare the knot. And I drive my knot. Attendez, montrez-moi parce que je suis gêné par le. Ok, Monica is going to give me an exposition. Oui, troisième. Perhaps a fourth, to be sure. Oui, soulève-moi un petit peu le vagin. Okay. So I keep the same stitch because I have sufficient length, and I'm going now to pass on the left side of the rectum, and for this time I use the back movement of my needle to start with the most dangerous part of the space in introducing the needle and to achieve. Excuse-moi, je dois passer dans ma fenêtre. So, okay. So, yeah. We have very safe contact with the muscle. And I have back movement of my hand just to be sure that the needle exits far off limit with the rectum. Okay, I take care with the distal part of the stitch. I take the middle part of the left leg of the mesh and I fix the knot. Oui. Oui, Monique. Oui. Juste le nœud parce que le fil est très court. OK. Un peu plus long, un peu long, hein. So I keep the same stitch to achieve the distal and posterior fixation of the mesh with the little point on the middle line which is fixed on the posterior limit of vagin and which must be very superficially to avoid to be transfixed and of course to avoid to be in contact with the rectum. So you can see it's quite easy to access. In this case I just pass on the limit between rectum and vagin and my assistant as contact and if feel if I have risk to be transfixant and I just drive a needle in the part of vagin to fix the middle part of the mesh to avoid any risk of possible prolapse between vagin and mesh. Okay. Attends. Non, je vois pas Monique. Ah, laisse tomber, laisse tomber. Mais je le vois pas. Voilà. Oui. Encore un. Okay. So perhaps I need to have a little coagulation on the left part of vagin because I don't want any risk of bleeding. Hey, montre-moi Monique s'il te plaît. Ici tu vois j'aimerais bien le... Hey, montre-moi. I think it's correct. So we have achieved the posterior and distal fixation of a mesh, and I would like to show you what's the effect of this time. On va exposer la mèche pour montrer le... Voilà. Voilà. So we are going to track the mesh, and you can observe that behind limit of mesh, you have a very large aspect with of safe space between external limit of rectum and the mesh, very good aspect between left limit of rectum and mesh, and fixation of the mesh. If you pick directly in vaginal wall, you have risk of transfixion, of necrosis, and infection of the mesh. And so it is used to say that we have to avoid any transfixion, fixation of mesh in a vagina. So I use to use this running movement of my hand, and I pick in heterosacral ligament. I pick external limit of the mesh. Oui, zoom un petit peu, Monique. You see it very nicely. And I used to pick in the same time external limit of posterior incision of peritoneum to start the time of peritonization of the mesh. And it is a simplification of microil points, which is fixing the posterior limit of the Douglas peritoneum and the mesh. Excuse-moi, Monique, laisse-moi attraper ça. So I reduce lines of stitch. And so it's possible to cut. So on the right side, I'm going to start directly on the heterosacral ligament with a back movement of a needle. I place needle like this. I invert sense of and position of needle, and I go. Attends, passe la derrière. Ok, montrez-moi l'utéro sacré. Oui, zoom un petit peu vers le haut. And I'm going to pick just here, and not too large because, as Arno Vatias said, due to this morning, you have risk of contact with your tear, which is really possible on the right side. Yes, little more. Yes. No. Excuse me. Yes. Attends, je le fais. Yes, and third one. Okay, at this time, on fait le petit point de fermeture du. This time, it's possible to start or to go on with peritonization, with passage of the stitch just Yeah, un peu plus au milieu. On the middle part of peritoneal limit of Douglas, and it continues to close the space between the posterior mesh and Douglas. Okay. Attends, excuse-moi. Ah, oui. Voilà, très bien. Yes. Yes. So, one of the most difficult time of this surgery is achieved. It's a time of posterior dissection to be sure that you have a good visual contact with rectum and access with the muscles, and time of fixation of the mesh. So now we are going to start the anterior part of treatment of prolapse. So we start with a preparation of passage in the parameter of the right side to pass the mesh. I remind you that Arnaud Saidou, that risk with your tear is on the lower part of this field. So you go on the medial and superior part. Non, attends, Monique, regarde-moi là. Soulève-moi un petit peu. And progressively, you can push your dissection to avoid risk with vascular system of uterus and with your tear, and progressively you will find just in contact with the peritoneum on the anterior part of parameter, and we are going to find it just after division of uterus attachment. Voilà, on va se retrouver de l'autre côté. So we are going, so we let down uterus and we find immediately the anterior part of peritoneum, which will be the place of... J'ai un petit faux contact dans ma coagulation. Ouais. Attends. Okay. So now we are going to start the dissection between bladder and vagina. So you have very good access here, and you can see that it's possible to identify a mobile part of peritoneum between bladder, which is in the upper part of field, and uterus. And you have not to be too close with uterus because it's a bleeding plane, but you can observe that this plane... J'ai plus de coagulation, là. You can observe that this plane is a free plane. You have to insert, and progressively the gas is going to define the good space of dissection between anterior part of vagina and last one. So I have to enlarge just a little more because I used to pass anterior mesh just on the right side, so I don't need a too large exposition of this plane, but I need a sufficient plane to be sure that I have a full dissection of prolapse and a full fixation of the mesh on all the limits of the vagina. So I drive very gently my dissection. You can observe that visual definition of vagina is very good. Vagina is here. And, attends, doucement. And progressively, I'm going to enlarge. The space between bladder. You see bladder very nicely and the superior part of the field. And and vagina in the lower part. So Francisco is going to use now the blade, and we need it because it's difficult at the end of the time of the section to be sure of the limit of bladder. And in this, attends, je reprends une bipolaire. Attends, excuse-moi. In this case, you have very good definition. Tiens, attends-moi, Francisco. Attends deux secondes. Ouais. So in this case, you have a very nice definition of the two limits. What is little red? It's the bladder, and what is white is the vagine. So abaisse un tout petit peu et, et rétracte-la un petit peu. Je suis en bout de voilà, très bien. And you need to have this very smooth dissection to incise and to start to identify the space between the two structures, and progressively your dissection is becoming more and more easy. So at this time, it is said that perhaps it is less dangerous to have injury of bladder than injury of vagina, because it's very easy to make suture in the bladder wall in case of injuries. But it can be more difficult in vagina because of risk of bad cicatrization and infection. Soulève un petit peu, s'il te plaît. Non, non, la vessie. Voilà, très bien.
Thierry.
So,
Thierry, do you hear us? Do you hear us? Thierry?
Yes. J'entends pas le micro.
In such a case, how far do you need to dissect the vagina from the posterior bladder wall?
I think that one of the good landmarks is to see the posterior aspect of balloon, and your assistant tracked. Pull on the Foley catheter to fix the balloon in contact with the bladder neck. And when you see the posterior limit of balloon, is to say that you have just in contact with the trigona and you have not to go more distally because you can induce after functional disorders of trigona and urethra. So I hope that we'll have possibility to show you this landmark. I go very slowly because. It's fixed. I have not a free space for this time between bladder and vagina, so I go very progressively to avoid any risk of injuries. Oui, écarte un peu comme ça, Monica, et comme ça là, tu vois. Fais attention, n'écarte pas trop parce que. On est sur la partie, on the distal part of prolapse, the part which was outside of the vaginal limit. So always in this kind of situation, you have inflammatory reaction on bladder, and it can be more difficult to find the good space. But I think that I'm quite an happy man because space is quite easy to find. You have to remember that your tears were included in the prolapse. So it's to say that you have to be sure that your dissection is in the good space to avoid any risk of injuries or section of your tear during this time of distal dissection. It's very important because there are some accidents with this surgery of urethral injuries and urethral section. So I go on progressively. Yes, soulève un peu, Monique, s'il te plaît. Yes. So you see very slowly, very gently, you search your space. And I think that we are going to access to this level of... Attends, excuse-moi, je voudrais voir ça, Monique. Ouais, doucement, hein, pour pas. Très bien, excellent. Ici, on va devenir un peu plus superficiel. Oui, un petit peu ici. Yes. OK, ici je peux. So I just need to go a little more distally on the middle line and to achieve the left side to be symmetric and okay. Alors, est-ce que tu peux, Francisco, can you move the Foley catheter? So we start with the distal part on the left side. So I place my needle before exposition. Okay, and I need to go. Non, excuse-moi, je suis pas bien. I need to go as distally as possible and very superficially to avoid risk of transfixion of the vagina. And I just achieve movement of the needle without picking posterior limit of bladder, because as you know, you have risk to induce vesico-vaginal fistula if you pick the bladder with your movement of needle. So I prepare. Yes? Non, c'est bon, c'est bon. We are going to check what's bleeding to be sure to